Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey from GavTrain.com, and in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this really simple but powerful black and white effect, but I'm going to keep one color only in the image. Okay, so how's it done? Well, it's actually done using Adobe Camera Raw. So let's get a picture into Raw. Now, I'm going to open Mini Bridge here because I'm in Photoshop CS6 Beta, but if you're in Photoshop CS5, you can use Mini Bridge as well. If you're using an older version of Photoshop, then use Full Bridge, and it'll work the same way in Full Bridge. Because to get into Adobe Camera Raw, well, if it's a raw file like this one, you just double-click it. But in Mini Bridge or in Full Bridge, if I right-click a file, I can choose Open With Camera Raw. Now, that'll open up a JPEG even into Camera Raw, even if it wasn't a raw file, but please shoot in Raw if you possibly can. Okay, so got my image into Adobe Camera Raw. What am I going to do next? Well, really anything I want to. I'm not going to touch temperature, tint, vibrance or saturation. I'm not going to touch the color, but everything else is up for grabs. So exposure, I think that's about right. Contrast, well, maybe we'll take the contrast down a bit and bring the highlights down and the shadows down a little bit like that. So we can just make a few basic tweaks in here just so it looks a little bit better. And of course, I'll put the clarity up because I happen to rather like clarity. So that makes my picture look more the way I want it, but it hasn't made the color disappear apart from the reds. How do I do that? Well, here comes the really neat, really impressive, ever so simple trick. I'm going to jump over to the HSL / grayscale tab. Now here there are three sort of tabs within the HSL grayscale. There's the hue. Now hue is all about color. You can change colors completely. So for example, you can make blues go green. Saturation is all about making the individual colors either more colorful or more monochromatic. Luminance is all about making the individual colors much brighter or darker. Now, it doesn't take a genius to work out that what I want to do is use saturation, because I want to make every color black and white except for the reds. Okay, these phone boxes are really the only red thing in this picture. So if I make everything black and white, those are going to stand out like a sore thumb. So let's do it. Let's get the magentas and I'll take them all the way down. There's not really much magenta in the picture. Same with purples. There's not really much purples in there. Probably not a lot of blues in there either, but when we start to get into the aquas and greens and the yellows particularly, look at the grass in the background. So I'm going to take this all the way down to -100, and that means the color disappears in those greens. Same with the yellows, take them away, and now I'm left with a pretty much a monochromatic image, but I need one more. There's a bit of orange, and I can see the orange is kind of here in the building, so if I take the orange all the way down to -100, that just leaves me with the reds. Now, I can play with the reds as well, so I don't have to leave it here. It's the default position. I can make my reds brighter by increasing the red slider. So I can have much more saturated red or a much more muted color. So I've still got the ability to play around with these. And of course, if you're doing this with your own images, you don't have to stick to reds. You could choose any color or combination of colors. Now, I could stop there, but it's well worth looking at your images up close and just seeing what's really going on. So let's go have a real close look. Reds look good. See, not even a selection in sight, no marching ants, anything. As I go across here, though, there are some other red bits coming in. So the red sort of light on the back of the bicycle here and on the posters, those are still red as well, and they get picked up too. So how do I deal with those? Well, I could just leave them. Maybe I don't have to worry about them, but I think I'll do something by getting the adjustment brush. And on the adjustment brush, I'm going to reset everything and bring the saturation down to -100. And now I can just paint -100 saturation on those areas, and as if by magic, the red will disappear. So I'm just going to move around the picture by holding the space bar and just kind of removing anything that wants to go. Now, obviously, you can zoom out and do this quicker, so perhaps we'll do that. We'll just hit the minus button there, we'll zoom out a couple of times, and we'll just get it there all clean of reds like that. There's a bit on the tree there that needs to go, and there's a bit here on the path, which is really the reflection of the phone boxes, I think, in the little puddles, but we'll lose those two like that. Okay, so there we are. I've cleaned this image up, and now the only thing that's left in color are the red phone boxes, but the picture just looks a little bit flat and lifeless. And you'll often find this when you make a black and white image. You end up with something that really doesn't have much excitement in the shot. So let me come back to the basic panel, and here I can change everything. So this is the beauty of working in RAW, it's totally non-destructive. So I can get my contrast, which I took down earlier, and push it up. I think with black and white, a bit more contrast is often the way to go. The highlights I can bring down a bit further, and the whites will bring down. There you go. So now we're starting to get something that looks much more edgy and much more contrasty and fits the whole black and white idea much better. Still looks a bit bright in the corners, so let me just jump over to the effects tab and we'll put a bit of post-crop vignetting in there just to darken those corners down like that. So there you go. We've gone from the original image, which is that one right there, and by simply changing the HSL stroke grayscale tabs and a few basic sliders, we get to that. Hit the open image button and you'll leave Adobe Camera Raw behind and end up right here back inside of Photoshop with your completed image. So if you want to find out more about me, don't forget to visit my website at www.gavtrain.com. I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.